Hello, this is Larry Williams with the University of Florida Extension Office in Okaloosa County. Today we'll be looking at ground pearls and taking a look at diagnosing ground pearl problems in a lawn. Behind me is a zoysia grass lawn that's thinning and beginning to become weak, and weeds are growing in those weak areas, and we're about mid-April, and this is the time that ground pearl damage begins to show up. So we'll be doing a little closer look and some digging, actually digging in the soil in the root area to see if we can uncover the true culprit, which I believe will be ground pearls. Here's the zoysia grass lawn that's thinning and showing some symptoms or evidence of ground pearls. And you can see these, for some reason, it causes these circular serpentine lines that are relatively narrow to begin to form. That's a symptom that you need to learn to look for. And sometimes they'll become circular, but you can see this kind of a serpentine declining area, which is characteristic of ground pearl damage. And here again, you see this brownish area that's weakened and thinning, and it's kind of a circular or serpentine pattern. And a bigger pattern, sometimes you'll start seeing areas like this that begin to thin and become weed infested. But again, you'll see those thinning areas that are somewhat serpentine and sometimes even somewhat circular in pattern. You don't always see that, but that's characteristic of ground pearls, and I would start suspecting ground pearls. So we're gonna take a look at how to dig into this area and see if we confirm whether or not we have ground pearls. We're looking for ground pearls and some zoysia grass. A lot of times it's thought to be more of a problem in centipede grass lawns. This is a scale type insect, and this is mid-April. This is the pink female. It's soft-bodied, it's kind of a pinkish purple. And then there are also pearls, and there you see it's smaller than a BB in diameter, but in the root zone, usually at the surface down to several inches. If it's drier weather, they may be a little bit deeper, but there you see the pearl stage. And that is a protected stage of the scale insect. And as we kind of sift through the soil, we'll probably find more. And you see those little pearls in there. And you can see them all through here. This is, again, less than the size of a BB, and they play havoc in lawns. There's really no chemical control, unfortunately, and you just have to deal with them and managing the lawn correctly, trying to keep it fertilized correctly, mowed at a higher setting, and fertilized and correctly is the key in good management. Unfortunately, there's no chemical control that we know of that really can solve this problem. And when you look at what it looks like, you'll see areas that begin to thin out. And when we go through dry periods, it will be obvious that those areas are weak. So here you can see the number that I collected in a relatively short period of time. You see the females, the pinkish purple females that are soft-bodied. That's kind of a crawler stage. If you look at it with some magnification, you can see that it's a true insect in that stage. And then you see the ground pearls. They get the name pearl because they look like almost a shiny little pearl, but they're less than a BB in size. You can see the reference to size to that dime. And having this many in less than a square foot area in the root area of the zoysia grass lawn indicates there's a heavy population, and you would expect to see some damage, some thinning, a weak area in the lawn where the ground pearls are feeding. For additional information on ground pearls, contact the University of Florida Extension Office in your county, or you can access this publication online by searching ground pearls followed by IFAS. That's IFAS, which stands for the Institute of Food and Agricultural Sciences, As you can see, this publication includes written information as well as photos. Here you see some ground pearls. This is the mature female ground scales, which is soft-bodied, and they're kind of a pinkish purple in color. And then you see the pearl stage. Please let us know if this video was helpful by calling the UFIFAS Extension Office in Okaloosa County at 850-689-5850.